Future Ventures invested in women apparel brand Biba in 2007. And then there was no looking back for Siddharth Bindra, MD of the company. Biba will be opening another 100 outlets in the next 2 years. It is already present in 47 cities and wants to be in 100 cities. The immediate capex plan is to spend rupees 50 to 60 crores on operations and spend another rupees 30 crores on marketing. Bindra is even looking to raise funds in the next financial year. The brand, which has an expertise in women ethnic wear, is now also focusing on a kids brand and side by side will be coming up with a budget brand for women next year. In an exclusive interaction with VCCircle, Bindra discusses how he's looking for another round of funding, his thoughts on an IPO, and how Biba will ultimately become a rupees 2000 crores company in the next 5 years.
So we are in the head office of Biba Apparel, which is a premium brand in women apparel, and we have Siddharth Bindra with us. Hi Siddharth.
Hello.
In 2007, when Future Ventures invested into your brand, how has the journey been till now? And how has the company grown?
We've had a very exciting journey ever since. Retail is a very capital intensive business. That's the reason we raised money at that point. We are very lucky and fortunate to have got very good investors on board, Future Ventures, very mature investors, very educated about the retail industry, and been absolutely fabulous with us at the board and helped us think through our strategies and grow correctly. We have grown very aggressively since then. When Future Ventures invested in us, we were 30 crores of top line. We hope to close at 350 crores in the current year and hope to be 500 crores in the next year.
It was 2007 when your initial funding came, and since then it has all been your own financial planning that the company has expanded. Are you looking at raising funds in the near future for further expansion? Which is, you have an aggressive expansion plan of 100 outlets.
That's right.
So how will that happen?
I mean, we are profitable. We should be at an EBITDA margin of 18 to 20%. For us, our own stores are very profitable. Our own standalone stores are operating at an EBITDA margin of 27 to 28%.
Okay.
And so we are generating enough cash to immediately to meet our immediate business plans. We are looking at acquisition for other brands below Biba and other opportunities that do come by. So I do see ourselves now raising funds once again, probably in the next financial year. Our capex plan over the next 2 years is approximately 50 to 60 crores.
Okay.
We are also looking at spending around 30 to 40 crores on the brand over the next 2 years.
That is through marketing.
That is through marketing.
So what would you attribute this growth to, from 30 crores to 350 crores?
I think to the huge retail opportunity available in India. There is such a large opportunity for branded clothes. There is a huge shift happening from unbranded to branded clothes. I don't have the exact category figures, but KSA figures quote this entire size at 80,000 crores. And Biba, being the market leader, is not even 0.5% of market share.
Okay.
So it's an absolutely huge market. So I think we still have a long journey ahead.
Okay. So how many outlets do you have right now?
We are 101 stores as of today.
And what is the number that you plan to reach in the near future?
We set ourselves a plan of adding another 100 stores over the next 2 years.
Okay. And how will this route be? Will it be through like single brand or multi-brand?
No, I think Biba is a single brand. We open single brand stores. In Biba, we have four distinct categories. We sell salwar kameezes, mix and match, unstitched suit pieces, and the kids wear range. So four distinct categories, but all housed in one shop under one brand. They're mostly company owned. So out of the next 100, at least 80 or 85 will be company owned, company operated. And probably around 15 would be through the franchise route. We started franchising around 2 to 3 years back.
Okay.
I think when we started going into tier 2 and tier 3 cities, that's where we realized we really needed help on the management bandwidth at the local level for the store. And a local entrepreneur who's a Biba franchisee really understands that market better, is able to service the consumer better. And that's where we went in for a franchise route to address markets.
Which of the routes would you consider a more economical route as a businessman?
No, we definitely prefer the company-owned model because we are in the business for the long term. We believe our core business is retail. So we'd like to invest in our stores and be able to manage our stores ourselves. But given the huge geographical spread all over the country, if I give you an example like Belgaum, we have a very successful franchise store in Belgaum, but we have no more distribution in Belgaum. So for the company to go and just operate a single store in Belgaum, we will never do it as effectively as a local franchisee would be able to manage their business. And that's why we have a franchisee as a partner there to help us manage their business.
And you also had recently a JV with Manish Arora for your designer outfits. How will this picture in the overall categories that you offer? And what other plans do you have in terms of diversification into different segments of apparel?
Sure. So, in Biba, we want to remain focused within the women's category of business and fashion and apparel. Manish has given us an opportunity to be able to address the luxury part of the market. Biba is addressing a certain segment. Manish is addressing the luxury segment. In Biba, we have a large range of apparel, but we still don't address the bridal segment. Our joint venture with Manish helps us do that too. So we get a direct entry into the bridal wear market. We get an entry into the luxury wear market. Biba spans a large part of the market segment below that. We also plan to come out with another brand in the value segment that is below Biba, which would be retailed through hypermarkets and that kind of distribution.
And by when can we expect that?
We are hoping to start that by autumn winter 13 or maybe summer 14.
Okay, so it will be more the price, there will be a pricing difference?
There would be. There should be at least a 20 to 30% pricing difference.
And what made you feel the need to do that?
I think the overall vision that I have for the company is that Biba should be able to address all apparel needs of a woman or all women ethnic apparel needs of a woman across income and across geographies. So we would have different brands catering to different income levels in different geographies, but have an entire portfolio that could be retailed all over the country.
So there are some overseas plans, you know, that we've been hearing for quite some time, that how and why do you plan to go to overseas?
Why? There's a huge opportunity.
Okay.
There is a huge Indian diaspora, Indian Pakistani, Southeast Asian, across a lot of countries, namely Singapore, South Africa, Dubai, America, UK. So huge markets. We do some business there already through some of the large retail stores. So huge business opportunity, but not something that we are immediately focused to. We definitely want to go to those markets and plan to address those markets by 2014 onwards.
Okay.
We currently believe Biba could retail in 100 cities in India. We are currently only in 46 cities.
Okay.
Some of our cities are underrepresented. So in Bombay, I have 17 stores, while Chennai has only 3 stores. So there is still a huge opportunity available within the country. And that is what we are really focused
100
on.
100 cities within?
Within India.
Within India. But as an apparel retailer, what do you think, that having standing alone is better, or going through malls is a better idea when we talk of real estate cost in the country right now? Because everybody says that malls are very greedy when it comes to real estate, because that's the only way they are making money.
Right.
So what sense does it make for a retailer to open an outlet?
I think you have to have a mix of both. I think mall is the way ahead. 85% of my stores are currently in malls.
Okay.
And in tier 2, tier 3, we are going to more high street stores. But malls are fabulous shopping experiences. They are, I don't see malls going out of fashion. I only see them growing further. And I think the mall market has also matured, mall developers have matured, so people are creating good shopping centers and experiences now.
Have you seen any change in the rentals in the last 5-6 years?
Yeah, 5-6 years is a, I mean, I would say in the last 2-3 years, we've definitely seen a lot more rationalization.
Okay.
I think things had reached a level where they were totally unaffordable. Few brands have gone out of business. So, I think things have rationed out and things have evened out. As a retailer, I still believe it's very expensive. It is a challenge. We are all trying to grow with it. I think there needs to be some rationality to some of the pricing that is taking place. I find some of the high streets pricing very irrational. We've still not been able to find a store in Southex because it just doesn't make financial sense as yet. So, I mean, there will be certain high street markets which are prohibitive. But we continue to look for an opportunity within them, and I'm sure we'll find the right store at the right price soon.
And also you mentioned some figures about the growth that you are expecting in the near future.
We've averaged around 35-40% CAGR over the last 8 years.
Okay.
We hope we should be a 2000 crore turnover company in the next 5 years. We should be able to continue our CAGR over the next 5 years at a 35-40%.
So, how many of your stores that are presently there are profitable right now?
All our stores are profitable. We're lucky. We, as I said, we're very conservative to business. So, we're normally able to get a cash break even in the first few months of operation.
Okay.
And an EBITDA positive within the first year of operation.
As a consumer, we've seen Biba evolve over the years. And you know, recently you've entered designer wear. Do you think you're confusing the consumer somewhere by having designer brand? Secondly, having the regular brand that you have been carrying out and coming, entering another brand. So in the future, will this be like equal divisions for Biba? What's the forte that we will see in your brand?
So I think there is no overlap. The vision for the company is to be able to, as I said, cater to all apparel needs across incomes. Which means we would have different brands to cater to different needs and requirements. Our joint venture with Manish is in a separate entity, it's a separate company. It will operate independently, of course, with our support and help. Manish Arora would open its own independent stores.
Okay.
We would give a, he would retail from some of our premium stores, but not all of them, probably not more than 20% of them. So, I mean, that would be run like a separate entity, a separate business. Obviously, if we, wherever we feel the potential of being able to leverage that product, or where our consumers would be having a demand for the luxury product, we would add that into our product.
What kind of acquisitions are you looking at?
As I said, we're looking for a brand for the value segment. We've not been able to find a brand for the value segment which we could really invest into. So, if we are not able to, we would create that brand ourselves. Yeah, within Women Ethnic, we're looking for a brand that could be below Biba and which would cater to the value segment.
Okay.
So, I think that's the basic requirement of the brand.
Also, any plans of going for an IPO later, or I mean, what's your perspective of having an IPO in this for your company?
We would definitely go to the capital markets, but as I said, I think we are looking more at raising a private equity route next year, and probably once the private equity route is raised, then we would be well funded for another 2 to 3 years.
Okay.
Post which I think we would look at the capital markets.
And also last year you entered the kids segment.
Right.
You know, which is already very competitive with established brands like Lilliput and, you know, even Mom and Me's entering into the kids apparel.
Right.
So how has the experience been since 2011 in this, in the kids apparel segment, and how do you plan to go about it?
It's been very exciting. We actually find a vacuum of brands in the kids' wear. I think lots of the brands are having their own internal issues. Especially within the women's kids' ethnic wear market, there is no brand really. It's all regional players, very localized. This is our first full year of operation in kids, and we should be at around 15 crores of business. We hope to be a 50 crore brand in just kids' wear business in the next 2 years.
Okay.
So, we would have built up a 50 crore kids' wear brand in 3 years' time, which is very exciting for us.